protection on range alpha, range A. If the flag is not up, you go ahead and raise the flag and go to the sign-in station. From the sign-in station, once I've signed in and I know that my badge is displayed, I'm cleared to enter the range. If I arrive on the line and the line is cold, I cannot enter the shooting stall. The firing line isolation cable is out. That signifies there's people downrange and the line is cold. Therefore, I am cleared to ground my equipment on the yellow line. Not after the yellow line, not forward of the yellow line. Remember, this walkway cannot be blocked with any equipment. Therefore, if you've got excess equipment, you should either put it off the firing lane or on the yellow line. It's the only two places you can do when the line is cold. As you can see, I've arrived when the line is hot. Therefore, I'm clear to get into my firing stall. If I got a way to put up a target, I'll just stand there and wait. We'll go through the line clearing procedures for range alpha. To do this, I'm going to assume the role of the RSO, the default RSO. To call the line cold, the very first thing I do is come all the way to the right, grab the firing line isolation cable. I can run my checklist right here. I come down to cease fire, cease fire. Cease fire, cease fire. Unload and safe all guns. At this time, everyone will back out. Now, I, as the default RSO, will take and check all the positions to ensure that they comply with the checklist that's found on the side of the shooting stall. The line is cold, shooters are clear downrange. We're bringing the line back up hot again. I'm the default RSO, so I have to ensure that everyone has returned from downrange. I've got a good head count of everybody that went down there and everybody's back. I have done that. I check with my checklist here on the side. Prepare for live fire. At this point, everyone should be installing their hearing protection, their eye protection. They are not cleared into the stall until I call line hot. Once I've stowed the cable, follow the next step on a checklist. Already on the firing line. The line is hot. Now everybody's cleared into their shooting stalls. All right, I have completed my firing for the day. Therefore, remember muzzle discipline. Never sweep that muzzle. Muzzle's always downrange at all times. I'm ready to, if I'm gonna relieve spring tension, I can do that now. The line's still hot. Put it in my case. Police up all my equipment, and I'm cleared to cross the yellow line and leave. Remember, never, ever, ever cross this yellow line with an uncased weapon of any kind. That will keep you out of trouble. It'll keep us safe. We've arrived at the range. Remember, according to the rules, your weapon cannot come out of its case until you're on the firing line. Therefore, I make sure I have my targets are not inside the case, everything else. This case cannot be opened until it's forward of the yellow line when the line is hot. So now let's go down to range B and go through that setup. Now I want to, after I've signed in, I want to go ahead and select a position on the firing line. As you can see, when I walk in here, you notice that the firing line isolation cable is up. That signifies the line is cold. Therefore, I cannot enter the shooting stall until I verify no one is downrange and follow the procedures as outlined in the SOP. What I can do right now is I can ground my rifle right on the yellow line. Not after the yellow line, not forward, right on the yellow line. I can drop my equipment and I can wait to go downrange when it's appropriate. One thing that's very important, do not open this case. If you put your targets inside or any equipment inside the case, it cannot be opened when the line is cold. Therefore, I highly encourage everyone, do not put anything but your rifle inside the case. Now, we'll go ahead and we'll clear the range. We'll go down and put up some targets. Remember, before we can go down range, we have to run the checklist. This is a mandatory procedure. Therefore, we start with ceasefire, unload and safe all guns. Through the line is cold, shooters are now cleared down range. Now that the line has been declared cold, both firing line isolation cables are up. We're cleared to the single point access gate downrange. What we want to do is we can put as many targets on the backer as we want, but we cannot overlap the backer. This is not good. Try and not place them over the wood because we got to replace the wood when it gets shot up. So place your targets wherever you want, whichever method you want. I'm going to use a staple gun. Also make sure that whatever lane you're set up on, you're set up on the same target. We're set up on lane 7, we're on target 7. That's very important. You cannot crossfire from one lane to the other. As the acting RSO, I must first ensure that everyone has returned from downrange before I can close the single point range access gate. I confirmed everyone is down, returned from downrange, so I close the gate. Running my checklist, prepare for live fire. After both cables have been stowed, I'm cleared to go ahead and continue running the checklist. The next step in a checklist is already in the firing line. By now, everyone should have their hearing protection in place, their eye protection, and now I declare the line is hot. Transitioning in from the yellow line to the firing stall, now I must bring up the importance of muzzle discipline. I don't know the condition. Remember, all guns are considered loaded, all right? So therefore, I want to make sure that my muzzle is pointing downrange. It's the only safe area right now. It's the only safe area anytime. So I open up my case, and I look, whoops, my rifle is pointing backwards, downrange towards the parking lot. I do not want to handle it in this condition. Therefore, I will flip it around before I take it out of the case. Very first thing I want to do is I want to open the bolt and confirm that it is unloaded. That's my starting point with every firearm on this entire range complex. You'd follow the same exact rule. Remember, muzzle discipline is the most important safety factor that we have out here. Always keep that rifle pointed downrange at all times. Always keep that pistol pointed downrange at all times. Never point it anywhere other than downrange. Once I place my rifle on the table, I can clear off all the superfluous equipment off. Now, you can put it underneath if you wish. You can put it all the way back towards the fence if you wish. But where you cannot put it is in the middle of this walkway. This walkway must remain clear at all times, all the way down the line, from target point 1 to target point 20. Nothing goes in this walkway except for the bottom of your feet. That's it. If you put anything in here, it's a tripping hazard. So, put my case back here. It's out of the way. Now the important thing to remember is, when your case is back there and your rifle is up here, the case goes to the rifle when you're leaving here. The rifle never crosses this yellow line unless it's in a case. That's an important safety factor we must all follow. All right, now I've completed my firing session for the day. I'm going to go ahead and case my rifle to remove it from the firing line. The line is still hot. Remember, I cannot remove this rifle from this bench. I cannot cross that yellow line unless it's in a case. Therefore, I bring my case to the rifle. Ensuring it's clear. If I want to dry fire, drop the spring tension, I can do that when it's pointed downrange. Never when it's not pointed downrange. Put it in the case, secure the case. Now I can remove my rifle from the firing line. Leaving the range is fairly straightforward. Go ahead and ground your case rifle. Sign out on the clipboard, make sure you got all your equipment policed up, and you're cleared to leave the range.